and gentlemen, today we will begin by honoring our Red Hawks who will serve our country and protect our freedoms. Presenting the American flag is Tyler Frazier. Tyler will serve in the United States Air Force. David Cruz is carrying the Michigan flag and will serve in the United States Army. Joshua Bartatovich will serve in the United States Air Force. Christopher Estrada will serve in the Army National Guard, and Ariane White will also serve in the Army National Guard. In honor of their sacrifice and with respect to our country, may everyone rise. Men, please remove your caps. Once the flags are presented on stage, please join in singing the national anthem. Good afternoon, members of the Board of Education, Deputy Superintendent Mr. Dajiak, Central Office Administrators, Athens faculty and staff, parents and family members, and graduates of the class of 2017. I am honored to welcome you to Troy Athens High School Commencement. Please allow me to also acknowledge my administrative team. Assistant Principal of the Class of 2017, Mr. Dan Mills. Assistant Principal for the Class of 2018, Mr. Bill Turner. Assistant Principal for the Class of 2019, Mr. Bob Dowd. And now, may all faculty with us today please stand. You are great teachers. You give of yourself and you use your talent and energy to help our students find their passions and develop their intellect. You build strong relationships and share of yourself and inspire and challenge future generations to push harder, learn more, be kinder, and overcome any challenge. Thank you for being exceptional teachers and people, and thank you for loving our Red Hawks. Thank you. Class of 2017, I am so excited to be with you today. I'm excited to celebrate you, who you are, where you've been, and who you will become. In many respects, today we celebrate your past, present, and future. And it could get a little tense. Ba-dum-bump. You know, kindergarten may not seem so very long ago for your parents. Earlier this week, my daughter came home from her last week of school with a self-portrait. She's finishing kindergarten. Like you, she's celebrating a milestone. While you are contemplating and considering the end of your childhood, she is just getting started. To set the little ones on a good path, Allie and her classmates were asked to envision themselves as graduates. It just so happened the principal was walking past her room and saw that Allie was upset. She walked over and asked her, "What's wrong?" Allie shared that she did not want to draw a red tassel on her graduation hat, as told by the teacher. She wanted hers to be green and white, for she was going to graduate a Spartan. So while her teacher was hoping to get kids to envision their high school self, Allie was already thinking well beyond. That moment, besides being a proud mama, made me think of all of you. I wonder, what were you like in kindergarten? Did you all know that you would be such talented, strong, creative, thoughtful, kind, courageous young men and women? Did you know that you would do such great things at Athens? Did you already envision more for yourself than those around you? Having been with you these last 4 years, I would venture a guess you very much did. So let's look at your present. You are the class the teachers say always exceed expectations. You are spirited, you bring it, you never disappoint, for after all, you are legendary. To recap, in the 4 years you've been at Athens, you've accomplished more, shared much, and are leaving a true unsurpassed legacy by previous Red Hawks. You are the reason Athens was honored this year, receiving Newsweek's top high school recognition, Nietzsche's 217 Best Schools Award, the Center for Michigan's Academic State Champion Award, Mackinac Center's Outstanding Achievement Award, Washington Post's Most Challenging High School Award. You are a big part of why we received multiple grants, like the 2017 Makerspace Grant, Steelcase Innovation Learning, and YSA Innovative Schools Grant. We pursued these opportunities because you inspired us to give you more. You are a class that has... You're a class that has smashed our record for students taking AP articulated and dual enrollment courses. You're also the first to complete our AP capstone seminar and research class. And wow, were your oral defenses and mini dissertations incredible. 10 of you are National Merit Commended Scholars. 12 of you are National Merit Finalists. 20 of you had a perfect SAT section test. 4 of you had a perfect SAT. And 2 of you had a perfect ACT score. Two of you said you would strive for the best academic record you can have, so 82 of you are co-valedictorians with above a 4.0 GPA. 127 of you, more than a quarter of the class, received first place state, national, and international awards in, and the list is long, bear with me, STEM, United States Youth Program, McCall, Michigan Film Festival, Student Television Network, Student Production Awards, NATSE's Film Awards, Michigan Interscholastic Press, Destination Imagination, DECA and Marketing, Breaking Traditions, Career in Tech Ed, First Robotics, Winter Guard, Chemistry Olympics, Cyber Discovery, German National Exam, Business Professionals of America, Goldsky, Scholastic, and Art Awards, Japanese Speech Contest, Japanese Quiz Bowl, National Exams, Future Problem Solvers, and Athletic Academic All-State. Wow. That means you are the top performers in our state and our country, and you are so well-rounded and so talented. This year, we also had two teams and three individual athletes compete on the state championship level, and 14 of our seniors will play college athletics. So as is tradition, now is a good time to note our triumph over our favorite rival in football, boys basketball, boys lacrosse, girls basketball, girls soccer, softball, volleyball, cheerleading, and a tie in boys soccer. Your accomplishments are so, so many. But what is most impressive about you is what Athens is all about. You are a class who has heart and incredible character. You are the people who tutored each other during lunch. You helped our preschool tykes. You tutored elementary children. You volunteered at hospitals. You've fed children and adults in soup kitchens. You coached Little League and summer camps. You also rake lawns for the elderly. You were links during school. You attended after-school events and cheered people on. You supported our new club of Circle of Friends game nights. You even helped me and a few of my colleagues when we were in need of a little more magic at the teacher dance-off. Thank you for that. You also helped our district and community with an amazing day of service, and you championed so many charities, including those started by your very own peers, Threads for Teens and Step on Poverty. You also championed the corner collection that was started by your teachers. You traveled to Punta Cana and Dominican Republic to provide supplies for children in need, and you helped support sustainable businesses in Africa. You traveled with Athens faculty and friends to places like Rome, Dublin, Paris, Germany, Mexico, Haiti, Uganda, Japan, and China, just to broaden your understanding of the world. You are people who give and explore. You are people who create and share. But the most poignant example of your heart was your leadership, generosity, and unbelievable kindness you showed this year to your two classmates, Jenna and Caroline, and the children in our state. Class of 2017, you touched my heart, and we are all so amazed by you. So, while milestones can be bittersweet, they are also so very precious. We are here at your commencement. The root word commence means to begin. Now is the time for you to envision your future self. What will your self-portrait look like in 10 years? Who do you want to be? And as you contemplate that, I want you to dream beyond yourself. I hope you will always be kind, continue to share your talents. I hope that you will take smart risks and keep your family and friends very close. I hope you laugh and love and are forever curious, that you honor your parents and hug them every chance you get. Class of 2017, honor your past, celebrate your present, and embrace your future. Thank you so very much for sharing this time with us. On behalf of all the staff, I know that your future self will be remarkable. So Board of Education, Deputy Superintendent Dajiak, and guests, with great pride, I and the Athens faculty present the graduating class of 2017. And now it's my privilege to introduce our keynote speaker, for she is an exceptional young woman. She is someone who is beautiful, inside and out. She is known for being kind, loving, reliable, strong, creative, and real. And if you ask her mother, she's also known for being perfect, as any loving parent would say. This Red Hawk is smart. She is also approachable. She is a good listener, a good athlete, and someone who always looks for what is needed and then steps up and does it with a smile and an open heart. While at Athens, she has been a 3-year serving STUCO secretary, president of STAD, JV and varsity soccer player, and member of the National Honor Society. She is an AP scholar with over a 4.0 GPA and a summa cum laude graduate. On a leadership advancement scholarship, she will attend Central Michigan University. Fire up, Chips! She'll be majoring in integrative public relations and political science leadership. Please join me in welcoming this future campaign manager, one of our best and very brightest, and someone I am truly grateful to have known and spent these years with, your classmate, Katie Preblick.
Good afternoon and welcome. Graduates, Board of Education, administration, faculty, parents, family, and friends. As I look around at the Troy Athens graduating class of 2017, I'm overwhelmed by how blessed we are and how much we have to be thankful for. Looking back on our 4 years together, I'm starting to understand why our parents, teachers, and school staff have always said that there's something special about our class. We reach higher, push harder, and finish stronger. Other people's goals are just our guidelines. And let's be honest, I feel a little bad for the class of 2018 that has to follow in our footsteps. But we would have not been able to accomplish all that we have and reach this graduation day without the help and guidance of some very incredible people. To the administration and staff at Athens High School, and in particular, Dr. Dixon, thank you for leading us from a place of yes and allowing us to learn lessons about community and charity that stretch far outside the classroom. The reason why teachers want to teach here and students want to learn here is because of the tone that you set. Athens would not be Athens without you. To the teachers who motivated and inspired us, even when we didn't want to learn, thank you for teaching us so that we would understand, not just going through the motions and teaching us enough to pass a test. We want to make sure that you know that when you spoke, we listened. When you taught, we learned. You believed in us, so we had to believe in ourselves. I'd like to say a personal shout out to Mr. Harrington, who taught me that I am in fact not a dumb blonde, and I can understand math. It was not an easy task, but he never gave up on me. I'm also so thankful for Ms. Pierce, Mrs. Chrysopoulos, Mr. Burns, and so many more who weren't just teachers. They became role models, mentors, and friends. And you have to thank a teacher like Mr. Outsema, who had missed his son's soccer game to come and watch one of his speech students give her last high school speech. To our parents and families, thank you for the endless patience through the trials and tribulations of our teenage years and for still loving us anyway. We appreciate the endless sacrifices that you've made to give us all of these opportunities. And we know that we would not be here today without your love, encouragement, and support. I hope that we have made you proud.
Oh.
There are two very special people from the Athens class of 2017 that aren't here with us today and deserve possibly one of the biggest thank yous for helping shape our class into the people that we are today. Jamel Foster was a student at Baker Middle School when he passed away in a canoeing accident Memorial weekend the year we were in eighth grade. Friends of Jamel will always remember his huge smile and crazy outgoing personality. His dream was to attend MSU, so for those of you who are going to state in the fall, please party on in his memory. And there's the girl who became a friend to us all this year, Jenna Cast, who taught us that miracles really do happen if you just believe. I know both of them are watching over us today. Oh. And finally, to you, my friends graduating with me today, thank you for making the last 4 years of high school amazing and helping to create so many unforgettable memories. While I can't wait to see what the future holds, I do know that a small part of me will always miss those Friday night football games, homecoming dances, spirit days, and, of course, the overwhelming excitement of Charity Week. I know that we will take the lessons that we have learned during our time here together at Athens and continue to do great things as we head off to college, learn a trade, serve our country in the military, or enter the workforce. No matter where life takes us, Athens will always be home. Nelson Mandela once said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which we can use to change the world." If anyone has the drive and determination to get out there and change the world, it is the Troy Athens class of 2017. I can't wait to see what we achieve. Congratulations. And now, as a tribute to our graduates and their families, conductor Adrian Kovian will lead the Athens Choir as they sing "Hold Me, Rock Me" by Brian Tate. Following, conductor Adam Cable and our symphonic musicians will perform Samuel Hazo's Arabesque.
Hold me, rock me, calm and easy. Hold me, rock me, deep and wide. Hold me, rock me, in your arms. Oh, I got a home on the other side. Hold me, rock me, calm and easy. Hold me, rock me, deep and wide. Oh, hold me, rock me, in your arms. Oh, I got a home on, I got a home on, I got a home on the other side. Someday, gonna cross that river. Someday, gonna settle on my own. Don't know where my journey leads, but I'll keep on walking till I get
Thank you. afternoon, I'm Ellery Thill. I'm honored to be here representing the class of 2017. As a member of the class, I've been involved in many sports teams, clubs such as Student Council, and of course, all of the classes offered at Athens. Through all these experiences, I've learned to always believe in myself, believe in my class, and believe in miracles. Our school district stands apart from other districts. This is certainly in part due to the fact that we have such a dedicated, encouraging, and inspirational group of leaders who push for us to be the best district it can be and to ensure that all children have the education and support they need to be prosperous, innovative, and thoughtful humans. Please join me in welcoming one of the many leaders within Troy, the assistant superintendent, whom I've had the pleasure of getting to know this year, Mr. Mark Dajiak.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hello, parents, family, friends, Athens faculty, Athens administration, members of the Board of Education, and to the class of 2017, it is very, very exciting to be here with you on this very special day, your graduation from Athens, here on June 10th, 2017. You may have noticed from Ellery's introduction and my listing in the program that I'm the deputy superintendent in Troy, not the superintendent. Your superintendent, Dr. Richard Macheski, sends his most heartfelt congratulations to our outgoing seniors and his thanks to all the families and friends who are here today who supported our newest alumni on their journey towards graduation. Dr. Macheski would have been here today if his daughter was not graduating from another high school happening now, right this moment, at another venue. But I'm here, and I'm proud to represent him and all the administrators across the district who are proud to say congratulations today to the class of 2017 at Athens. This is my third year as a central office administrator and my second as deputy superintendent. And I've learned something very important in those last few years. While people really listen to what the superintendent has to say, me, not so much. He's the headlining act, and I'm only the cover band. For the parents here, I'm sure you've had this experience. You got great tickets to see Journey in the early 2000s, and you realized that Neil Schoen and Steve Perry were not there, but the third bassist who tried out back in the 70s is part of the band. They still call it Journey, and you go to the concert. I'm kind of like the third, fourth version of Journey. So knowing that your attention span has been reduced considerably by the diminished stature of my title, I shall be brief. So class of 2017 from Athens, I want to share three quick phrases with you today. Thank you, wow, and see you later. First for the thanks. Thank you, Athens class of 2017, for being who you are and doing what you do. I believe this is one of Athens' finest group of graduates ever. I will not enumerate or revisit those accomplishments that Dr. Dixon talked about earlier in the program, and I'm sure others will share more of your accomplishments later in the program. But know that I know and your superintendent knows what you have achieved in your high school career, and it is amazing. Doing so is a tough challenge because of the highly accomplished graduating classes that have come before you. Now, I will tell you, I know a few things about the graduating classes that have sat in your seats years and years before that. Nearly 20 years ago, before all of you were born, I began my career as an educator at Athens High School. In June 1997, almost exactly 20 years ago today, Principal Dr. Bob Cross, that's five principals ago from Dr. Dixon, hired me to teach science, technology, and serve as the coach of the varsity cheerleading team. That's true, I was really the varsity cheer coach for 3 years. What I learned in that first year at Athens is that this school is a very special place. Its staff was phenomenal, its families were the absolute best, and its students were simply amazing. I learned that Athens was a place where students could dare to achieve great things, and they actually achieved them. You, the class of 2017, 20 years later, have not only carried on that special Red Hawk tradition, but have established a new standard for personal and academic success. For doing so, those in leadership positions across the Troy School District owe you a thanks. So, 2017 Red Hawk graduates, on behalf of all your teachers, principals, assistant principals, and the staff across the Troy School District, please accept my gratitude for taking on the challenge of high achievement incumbent upon every Troy Athens student and delivering results that have far exceeded that of your predecessors. Thank you. Secondly, I want to say, wow. Wow! 1 year shy of 20 years ago, when the class of 1998 from Athens High School, that was the first graduating class that I got to know, their charity week raised a whopping $2,500. They thought that was a big, big deal. Back then, the charity week consisted only of lunchtime Penny Wars competition and a moderately well-organized charity volleyball tournament. That was it. Interestingly, the class of 1998 thought that raising more than $2,000 was a big deal. Those seniors back then simply did not have the knowledge that you have. They did not know that setting big, huge, audacious goals does not set you up for failure, but to the contrary, it is the critical start in an ambitious march toward success. They did not know that everyone in the school had to be on the same page to achieve a lofty goal. Accordingly, they did not understand that once everyone started rowing in the same direction, more is achieved together than can be done individually. And finally, those graduates of yesteryear did not understand that linking purpose to task turns work into passion. Class of 2017, you have demonstrated that nothing can stop a group of audacious, connected, and passionate people. Nothing. And ladies and gentlemen, when our kids in Troy support their friends, give to help others, and change people's lives, there is only one word to express. Wow. Finally, class of 2017, we bid you farewell. But I've chosen the phrase see you later precisely because we want you to come back to visit. You are now and forever will be part of this Red Hawk community. For those of you on the Superintendent Student Advisory Council, please come back and visit Dr. Macheski and tell him how you're doing. Former athletes and actors, please come back to Athens on homecoming or in the spring at the musical to tell Coach Hepp or Mrs. Manfredi what's going on in your life. Musicians, come back for the concerts. Stucco, come back to the next big reveal. Since all of you are now graduate scholars, come back and visit your teachers. Athens is the special community that it is because of the strong bonds between the people in it. Don't forget that those bonds helped get you where you are today. So instead of a goodbye, we need to just agree to the phrase, see you later. Parents, families, friends, know that everyone in the Troy School District wishes only the very best for you and our graduates in the future. So class of 2017, thanks, wow, and see you later. Thank you. While our music representatives are taking their seats, I'd like to introduce a few members of the Board of Education to you that will not be speaking, but they'll be helping with diplomas later today. First of all, Secretary from the Board of Education, Mrs. Paula Fleming. Board of Education Trustee Gary Hoff. Trustee Elizabeth Hammond. Board Trustee Steve Gottlieb. president of your Board of Education, Dr. Nancy Philippart. And there's one more Board of Education that will be introduced in just a moment.
Good afternoon, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Mary Youssef. I've been a student at Athens for 4 years, and it has been one of the greatest experiences of my life to be part of such an outstanding group of people. I am very honored to be here speaking in front of all of you, but today is not about me. It's about all of us and all of the hard work and sacrifices we have made throughout these past 4 years to be here today. Class of 2017, you never fail to amaze me. Wherever our paths take us, we will always make a change for the better. After all, the biggest changes happen from the smallest impacts. Remember, always shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you'll land among the stars. My friends, the world is yours. Make the best of it. No matter where we go, we will always succeed. Troy School District is an exemplary school system, certainly due to the fact that we have such a strong group of leaders who are dedicated, hardworking, sincere, and optimistic about making our community a better place to learn and grow. Today, we have someone here who has been a part of the Board of Education for 10 years and whose daughter will be graduating with our class today. Someone who is an active member with the Athens Athletic Boosters and assisted in creating the infamous Bobby D. Burger. This individual has put in many hours to secure our education and make sure that all students have the help and support they need to succeed. Please join me with a warm round of applause in welcoming one of our Board of Education members, Mr. Todd Maletti.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Mr. Dijak, Dr. Dixon, Athens High School staff, parents, friends, families, and most of all, the extraordinary Red Hawk class of 2017. On behalf of the Troy Board of Education, I want to say how proud we are of you and all that you have achieved. Interestingly enough, do you realize that the class of 2017 is the last graduating class comprised of students born in the 1900s? Just yet another thing to make us parents feel a little bit older. Today we have and will continue to hear about the outstanding successes of your class, from academics to athletics to an amazing charity week total that may never be passed by any other class again. This is a record-setting graduating class for Athens High School. The class of 2017 has had many triumphs, but like most things in life, those victories rarely come without a struggle. I'm sure there were a few times in your high school career where you had to prove yourself, not just once, maybe twice, possibly even a third time. Sometimes when you stumble or you fail, it can be the greatest learning experience. In those cases, you can pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and try again, looking for that second chance to succeed. In contrast, when you are the victor, when you win, it can be quite disheartening when, through no fault of your own, your opponent is given an opportunity for a redo. Which reminds me, I'd like to take the class of 2017 back to the evening of Friday, October 28th, 2016. This was a perfect evening for high school sports. A clear, crisp fall night with some of Troy's best athletes on the field competing for glory, while the best concession stand in all of Michigan made Bobby D. Burgers for the crowd. The Bobby D. Burger. Succulent smoke pulled pork piled high on a cheeseburger with fresh coleslaw. It's a perfect combination of sweet and savory. But I digress. It was truly a night we will never forget. For those of you in the audience from out of town and maybe unfamiliar with the story, or perhaps you did read about it and considered it fake news, please allow me to recap. The night the boys' soccer team played in Macomb, Dakota in the MHSAAA Soccer Regional Final. The two teams played to a tie after regulation. Per the rules, they played a first and second overtime period, but still remained tied. Then the game came down to one of the sport's most dramatic methods to declare a winner. Penalty kicks. In the middle of the first round of PKs with the score still tied, things got interesting. Abruptly, the three referees gathered in the center of the field to conference, leaving everyone in the stands to speculate as to what was actually happening. As a side note, I will say that Troy Athens fans, most notably the parents, yeah, okay, maybe a board member, can be extremely creative when voicing their displeasure with the referees. There were quite a few gems verbalized that night during the 15 to 20 minute conference, most not suitable for this venue. But to give you an idea, such things were heard such as, could someone please put a tent over this circus? The three of you should put your heads together and make a rock pile. It's a good thing I DVR'd Shark Tank. I was confused the first time I saw a soccer match too. And my personal favorite, Foot Locker called, you're all late for work. And I swear I heard someone playing a theme from Final Jeopardy the whole time on their phone in the stands. The end result of that conference was to declare Athens High School the winner due to Dakota taking their penalty kicks out of order compared to the roster they provided to the officials. Game over. Athens rejoiced, regional champs, trophies presented, pure jubilation. But if I can quote ESPN's Lee Corso, not so fast, my friend. The next day, Athens Athletic Director Bob Dowd, also known as the godfather and the namesake of the Bobby D Burger. Bob, why don't you put your hand up, please? Helping with burger sales, appreciate that. Next day, Bob Dowd and Coach Hugh were notified by the MHSAA that the win was vacated and that the end of the game would need to be replayed due to the misapplication of a rule by the officials. Essentially, the MHSAA ruled that the State of Michigan tournament soccer rules did not require an ordered list of penalty kickers to be submitted. Therefore, they decided that the officials applied a non-existent rule to decide the game in Athens' favor. Consequently, they demanded the two teams replay the ending of the game from the end of the third round with the game tied and still two players from each team left to take a penalty kick. That's right, they authorized a redo. A redo. I've never heard of that before in sports. A redo. Conventional wisdom tells us there are no redos in sports, and actually a limited number of second chances in life for that matter. I mean, that's like all the husbands in the audience expecting their wives to marry them again, knowing what they know now. Which is why most men typically do not support redos. Or the Board of Education handing you a diploma this afternoon, then requiring you to return it to us before you leave the arena. And then you go home wondering whether or not you graduated. And then we give it back to you Tuesday. We actually thought about doing that as a joke, but thought it might be too soon. So, I mean, really, we're going to redo a regional championship. While Athens coaches and district administrators attempted to overturn the MHSAA ruling, their efforts yielded no fruit. The ending of the game was to be replayed on Tuesday, November 1st, 2016, after school at Athens. Understandably, the team was a little frustrated at first, but they quickly embraced the challenge. The Red Hawk student body turned out in force that day to support their team. The entire Troy School District community rallied around Athens. And with the grace of champions, seniors Mark and Shamik made penalty kicks 4 and 5. Dakota had made its fourth kick, so the game came down to the last PK. Dakota was set to kick against Mason, the senior goalie for Athens. The crowd grew silent, Dakota kicked, Mason made the save. The Red Hawk Nation went absolutely nuts. Athens was once again crowned regional champs, onto the semifinals, and ultimately landing in the state finals. Now that's how you do a redo. I thought a lot about that experience and what our Athens student athletes endured. Should they have been frustrated? How do you transition from frustration to focusing on winning the game again? Was this adversity character limiting, character revealing, or character building? Those are great questions for every person, every member of the class of 2017 to ponder whether you were a member of the team or not. How you respond to adversity, praise, injustice, penalties, rewards, and life's ups and downs often reveals the person you truly are. Character is built based upon how you respond to events in your life. I'm sure you know by now, life isn't fair. Deal with it, the way that Athens boys soccer team did. In the future, class of 2017, I know you will show your grit, whether you're faced with a redo, a bad hairdo, or some strange career voodoo. Dig in. Make something great happen, just like you did while a student at Athens. I remind you, Red Hawks, that during your high school careers, you've demonstrated great tenacity and achieved much success, whether it was absolutely dominating Troy High on the athletic fields, on stage in the auditorium, in classrooms, or networking within the Troy community, raising more than $155,000 for the Jenna Cass Believe in Miracles Foundation. You never gave up, and here you are today. Class of 2017, I challenge you to take the same qualities that helped you emerge victorious despite all of the unexpected do's, don'ts, and redos, and weave them into the fabric of your life. If you're ever given a second chance to right a wrong, then I encourage you to take a deep breath, place that ball on the field, and drill it into the back of the net. But if you're faced with an injustice, then I offer these words of advice. Channel your inner goaltender. Stand tall in the net. Do your best Mason Mathias impersonation, and you block that sucker. Congratulations, Athens High School class of 2017. Job well done.
Mr. Maletti, all I have to say is, wow, and thank you. It is my honor to introduce a remarkable young woman. She is someone who asks great questions, seeks challenges, leads with purpose, and always acts with integrity. She is well-rounded, hardworking, and creative. She devotes herself fully to every commitment. She is a runner, soccer player, and talented musician. She's co-founder of Got Cupcakes, intern for Wayne State's Regenerative Mechanics Lab, a Henry Ford nurse assistant, an active Model United Nations project lead and STU co-member, co-organizer and coach for Larson's Middle School Science Olympiad, executive board officer of Step on Poverty, vice president of the Indian American Student Association, and a Coca-Cola scholarship recipient. While at Athens, she has taken 17 AP courses, is a national merit finalist, and will graduate as summa cum laude scholar with above a 4.0 GPA, well above. This future Michigan Wolverine and businesswoman and engineer is truly the kindest, most generous, and devoted of philanthropists. I am confident she will help change our world. Please welcome your president of the Athens National Honor Society and your president of the senior class, Neha Paraji.
Thank you, Dr. Dixon. Welcome board members, administration, staff, families, friends, and last but not least, students, to this momentous occasion where we are celebrating the class of 2017. When I went to write this speech, I started off with a notebook and a pen, my go-to materials when brainstorming. I sat stumped. What did I want to say to my peers? To most, these would be the last words they hear from me, so I knew they had to be good. If you've had a class with me, you know I'm always on my phone or laptop. Sorry, teachers. I turned to my trusted friend, Google, and looked up good graduation speeches. My search revealed three things that make a good speech. One, it's funny. Two, it gives good advice. Or three, it tells a story. Seeing that my jokes are typically subpar and that I've experienced as much as the rest of you and probably wouldn't give very valuable advice, I decided that I would make my speech a series of stories. So imagine a book titled Athens, the story of the class of 2017. This book would be very different for everyone. The first chapter for most would start in September 2013 and recount the tales of freshman year. However, for a handful like myself, it would start in September 2012 as an eighth grade student. In eighth grade, I had the opportunity to come to Athens for math first hour. Every day for a full school year, I would come to Athens, but I never ventured past the front math hallway, probably because of those big and scary seniors. It seemed like a regular school, big and confusing. Little did I know, it was not just a regular school. It was big, confusing, and had no windows. Freshman year, the typical first chapter of high school. The first day of ninth grade was the first time I walked up the daunting stairs to the second floor. The tiny lockers lined the halls and the seniors loomed overhead. I got stuck in the typical jams found at every intersection of hallways. When I made it to first hour, I knew no one, but that was almost everyone's first day of school, a new place with new people and new opportunities. Luckily, I saw a fellow Stucco rep that I quickly went to sit by. Little did I know, sitting next to her that day would be the start of a friendship that's lasted over 4 years. Little did I know that eventually we would be working together as the president of student council and the president of the class of 2017. This was the first friendship of the countless I made that year. Freshman year was a time of exploration for many of us, especially when it came to friendships. Whether we are still friends with the same people or not, it was the first chapter in a wonderful story of high school. By the end of the year, this massive school would become a second home, and the peers in it, my second family. I'm beyond thankful for the friendships I made freshman year and the years that followed. I'd like to thank a few people in particular for being there for me the past 4 years. Joey, Chris, Varun, Jeremy, Peter, Justin, Neha, Tara, Alex, Claire, Audrey, Grace, Micah, and if I kept naming every one of the people I'm thankful for in this class, I'd honestly just read off the class list. The second chapter of our story, sophomore year, where we were no longer the new, little, innocent freshmen, nor were we the seniors that ruled the school. At everyone's favorite annual class meeting in September, we were told by our administration to find ourselves and start exploring all that Athens had to offer. Thus, we all set out on joining a plethora of activities Athens had to offer outside of classes. We hopped around to different class meetings to explore our interests. Beyond established classes, many of you even started your own clubs. A number became heavily involved in sports and music and went on to become leaders as underclassmen, a rare feat. I was overwhelmed by all these opportunities. But talking to students from other schools, I realized that we, as Redhawks, were so lucky to have all these chances. Some of our neighboring schools have a limit on the number of activities that run outside the classroom and even put a quota on the number of people that can be in the club. However, at Athens, that is not the case. We are extremely fortunate. I've been fortunate going to school here because I've been involved in music through playing the oboe, sports through soccer, and other extracurriculars such as Science Olympiad, HOSA, National Honor Society, and Stucco. In addition, the environment of Athens was extremely supportive in my endeavors to start two nonprofit organizations near and dear to my heart. This fact made me appreciate being a Red Hawk all the more. The third chapter in most of our novels is junior year. This is undoubtedly the most stressful year for us because of the never-ending standardized tests that bombarded our schedule. Like all of you, I was constantly studying to get a higher score on the ACT and SAT, in addition to the already heavy workload of school. One particular moment I remember from junior year is a November day. I was getting ready to take the SAT that was a couple weeks away, and I would carry my big yellow Princeton Review book to every single class and continuously study. My grades in classes started teetering as I struggled to balance the workload of normal school and standardized testing. That November day, I was carrying my book as I walked in to see my fourth hour teacher during passing time to pick up an extra credit packet. As I was going to grab the work, he asked me for my grade. After I said it, he blatantly told me he would not let me do the extra credit because he wanted me to study for the upcoming SAT. It was at that moment that I realized how caring, compassionate, and in general, amazing teachers at Athens are. In the last 4 years, I could easily say that every single one of my teachers was beyond kind and always concerned about their students. Even if they were drowning us in that busy work, it was for our own good. For that, I'm extremely grateful. Thank you, teachers, for making our high school experience a memorable one. the final chapter of our novel, Senior Year. It truly has been an incredibly memorable year filled with amazing experiences. And I really can't go through my speech without mentioning it at least once. So out of all the moments this year, my favorite was around 1:55 p.m. on February 10th, our last Charity Week reveal. $155,416.36. Earlier that day, when I was counting the final dollars, I honestly didn't think we would reach our goal. As every minute passed, the goal seemed more and more out of reach. However, the moment after the last number was revealed and the entire gym erupted in cheers, I wondered how I ever doubted the fact we would not surpass our goal. It is this amazing class that will lead the school to do the unthinkable. In the past 4 years, we have raised over $350,000 for four charities: Desert Angels, Wish Upon a Teen, the Joan Rose Foundation, and the Jenna Cass Believe in Miracles. Senior year in general has been stressful with college apps and future plans, but times like Charity Week have made this year the best year yet. Throughout the past 4 years, I have honestly said I hate school on a countless number of occasions. However, as I look back at my 4 years at Athens, it truly has been the best years of my life. The yearbook theme for this year is Make Our Mark, and for the past couple weeks, I've been pondering this topic. Today, I still do not know whether I've made a mark on this school, but as we leave Athens, I know it has made a mark on me. The shy middle school me that lost every single student council election until freshman year would have never imagined that as a senior, I would be standing up in front of the entire class delivering a speech at graduation. So, class of 2017, it has been an honor to be a part of such a phenomenal group of people that I know will go on to do amazing things. I am immensely thankful for all the experiences at Athens and the opportunity to serve as your class president the past 3 years. I'd also like to give a huge shout out and thank you to my parents, sister, grandparents, uncles, aunts, and cousins that all supported me the past 17 years and came out tonight. So at the end, as we go our separate ways, class of 2017, I wish you all the best of luck. You all have left a mark on me and on Athens. Now go out there and make your mark on the world. Thank you and congratulations.
Deputy Superintendent Mr. Dajiak, Board President Dr. Philippart, Board Vice President Carl Schmidt, and honored members of the Board of Education, on behalf of Athens Administration, faculty, and staff, it is with pride and pleasure that I present the class of 2017 and declare that they have fulfilled all requirements set forth by the State of Michigan and Troy School District, and hereby request that they are awarded their high school diploma.
Caitlin Lee Preblick. Ellery Rose Thill. Mary Khalil Yusuf. Neha Paragi. Mitchell Kendrick Wachowski. Elise Susanna Leverins. Tara Elizabeth Sachel. Joseph Hugo Stark. Jeremy Christian Clemente. Justin Hong Zhang. Emma Danielle Abed. Mohsen Ahmed Abyss. Isaac Abraham. Abdallah Abulaban. Avery Adams. Syed Arib Aftab. Mustafa Asan. Varun Itharaju. Mustafa Akhtar. Brianna Abbas Albadri. Jafar Aladari. Angelina Marie Alexopoulos. Kyle Anthony Alster. Daniel Joseph Ammon II. Christina Marie Andonizio. Lauren Paige Angelo. Sarah Rose Anthony. Matthew Servone Arnault. Robert O'Connell Arnold. Brandon Eric Austrang. Austin Joseph Babby. Sankit Rajiv Kumar Bagalkoti. Caitlin Cleo Baird. Mary Elizabeth Bologna. Paul George Balalas. Emmanuel Andrew Balmas. Kiana Banks. Michael Joseph Bariak. Andre Bogdan Barbolovich. Joshua Thomas Bakhtadovich. Jose Manuel Barrientos. Christine Elise Bassett. Ryan Riam Nashwan Batuma. Nicholas Henry Bauer. Ashley Nicole Baylor. Julia Rose Beach. Camille Suzanne Bedford. Catherine Marjorie Bell. Catherine Noelle Benish. Heidi Marie Birschbach. Alexander Joseph Beyer. Prahlad Bhagavatula. Amrit Krishna Bhaskaran. Iptida Bhuyan. Danielle Christine Bibber. Joseph Daniel Beaumier. Lindsay Marie Boots. Alexander James Bordo. Nicole Elise Borkosh. Christina Elizabeth Bowie. Jade Amber Bowen. Daniel Richard Brado. Harrison David Brado. Rita Zuhair Brijo. Sarah Rose Bussey. Gabrielle Hope Butcher. Angelica Perez Cabadu. Justin Brandon Tunicow Cano. Ella Christine Capuso. Edward James Romeo Carlton. Emma Grace Carney. Christina Elizabeth Carolyn. Tyler Devin Carter. Katrina Nicole Bernis Castellano. Lewis Parker Cavalier. Maxwell Zachary Cavalier. Jeffrey Larkin Sapiga. Michelle Chen. Joyce Chen. Pavani Chalukri. Rachel Choi. Benjamin Yojun Chung. Ryan Michael Sindrick. Trevor Scott Cleghorn. Ethan Michael Clifford. Karen Marie Comerford. Nina Christine Como. Isaac Alexander Cooper. Rachel Susan Correa. Brian Thomas Cottrell. Adam David Cowper. Michael Anthony Crenshaw II. David Guadalupe Cruz. Shirley Edith Cruz. Rocky John Coringa. Vivian Kim V. Dang. Pooja Kamal Dave. Claire Marlene Davis. Matthew William Dawood. Michael Ryan DeLong. Jack Wilk Depew. Nisha Pranav Desai. Thomas Michael DeShutter. Tanvi DeShmook. Joseph Dickow. Mary Dickow. Matthew Brian Dodoro. Derek Christopher Conley. Michaela Marie Dorflinger. Rachel Claire Draplin. Joshua Alexander Dufresne. Eler Duane. Akil Anthony Obadiah Eckford. Ashley Marie Edwards. Serena Eliza Elaniathara. Ethan John Elliott. Jacob Michael Elliott. Daniel James Engwall. Emily Danielle Irvin. Aya Omar Eshma. Christopher Lewis Estrada. Nadine Adil Faraj. Samantha Elizabeth Farhat. Hasib Farid. Parker Thompson Faubert. Nina Anastasio Felicidario. Christopher Sunny Lee Feng. Angelina Grace Ferrari Sneary. Andrew Henry Phillips. Caitlin Marie Fish. William Francois. Felicia Marie Franklin. Tyler Allen Frazier. Jenna Hope Gajovnik. Thomas William Gamble. Juliana Gao. Kelly Spencer Gapsky. Grace Irene Garrett. Marcelo Gashai. Ruth May Gazzetti. Elisa Julia Gefter. Peter Evan Georginas. Madison Michelle Glinsky. Griffith Henry Goodensmith. Madeline Patricia Goodman. Mitchell Stephen Gorski. Alexandra Michelle Graham. David Beaupier Grant. Samantha Aaron Granzo. James Douglas Grappin. Riley Griffiths. Adrian Caroline Gilbert. Kelvin Guo. Eric Stephen Gustafson. Nicole Alexandra Hasse. Nicholas Robert Halustak. Mafujal Hock. Lindsay Camille Harris. Lauren Nicole Hauerlach.
Hannah Eileen Hayes.
L'Oreal Kyra Hemingway. Nicholas Henson. Connor James Higley. Nicholas Jacob Holder. Miss Bahul Hoke. Rikai Hao. Abby Hausman. Royale Thomas Huckleberry. Nicole Marie Hughes. Drake Douglas Hunter. Sierra Danielle Nicole Hutchins. Alyssa Imamura. Tarek Imtiaz. Mark Iskander. Grant Edward Iverson. Matthew James Jackson. Armani Rakajia Jameson. Fawaz Jarbo. Hello. Samira Javed. Diana Mary Norma Jamoa. Selena Teresa Jendo. Aditya Ja. Faith Renaya Johnson. Kevin Ryan Jones. Gloria Minji Kang. Aubrey Faye Kapala. Gotham Srinivasan Karupia. Rayam Hadi Kachi. Varun Kaushal. Dustin Nathaniel Kellerman. Kayla Marie Keenan. Maria Elizabeth Califf. Manal Khan. Maria Kinzera. Caitlin Ann Klein. Justin Matthew Cook. Kyle Albert Cole. Benjamin Michael Kohler. Jessica Renee Marie Krolik. Lindsay Elizabeth Kumpala. Christina Jean Labadee. Miranda Star Lane. Sasha Malu Lapanza.
David James Lazarescu. Jonathan Lays. Ella Lazic. Patricia Sunyoung Lee. Rebecca Jane Lee. Leonard Likai. Ashley Lynn Leonard. Noah Sun Leong. Marcella Grace Lesnow. Alexander William Lester. Evan Nicholas Lester. Emily Rose Levine. Katerina Levy. Michael Lee. Jacob Alexander Lining. Jenna Ann Marie Liskey. Razin Manan Mahmoud. Emily Myroning. Kelsey Catherine Melvin. Vladimir Marinsky. Anne Eliza Marshall. Joseph Massimary. Sonia Massey. Tyler Matoyne. Grayson James Mazias. Mason Michael Mazias. Taylin McCaskill. Kevin Francis McIntyre. Caitlin Elizabeth McQueen. Muhammad Wahab Mir. Kyla Maley. Francisco Javier Mendoza Baruman. Stephanie Mendoza Hernandez. Jordan Christine Maletti. Christine Marie Miller. Rachel Lorraine Mitchell. Emily Heather Moe. Sebastian Christian Moldovan. Michelle Montenegro Cepeda. Brianna Nicole Montgomery. Joseph Scott Mooney. Kathleen Grace Ying Moore. Krista Marie Moots. Micah Amy Morey. Alexandra Claire Montier. Madi Muhib. Montserrat Mongia. Linda Hassan Murray. Joshua Daniel Muzlakovich. Lyric Marie Mirror. Michelle Bashar Nahas. Marissa Eileen Newfer. Yuki Tamar Grace Obayashi. Tyler Nicholas Obranovic. Sarah Elizabeth Osterling. Dina Veronica Olar. Salah Aldeen Osman. Yusuf Majid Faraj Pata. Jenna Grace Penz. Darren Keith Perkins II. Stephen Matthew Petrinko. Kevin Kyle Pazeski. Ryan Michael Patel. Gabriel Liam Plattenberg. Corey Mackay Ponder. Joey Pongrak. Alexandra Popa. Melina Popovsky. Regina Colleen Peretta. Rashad Rahman. Marisa Nicole Rapizi. Shakar Ratnam. Haley Michelle Rouser. Alana Rose Richardson. Haley Renee Robinson. Morgan Cynthia Robinson. Ellie Kate Rochelot. Nicholas Charles Rodolico. Nia Lynn Rodriguez. Alexis Michelle Rogers. Jacob Devin Ruffner. Jemiah Lachey Russell. Joseph Michael Rymus. Daniela Angela Surieja. Zarak Sajad. Alfonso Salas. Lorenzo Antonio Santilli. Varun Sethian. Catherine Nicole Schaefer. Dylan Michael Sibag. Benjamin Frazier Seifert. Kyle Emerson Salim. Nishal Sanker. Michelle Hao N. Shen. London Denard Shepherd. Megan Ann Schimmel. Martin Mazen Shiraji. Yonan Shucker. Sefir Siddiqui. Alexander Francis Simon. Navpreet Singh. Michelle Slimak. Aaron Robert Small. Brendan Grant Small. Samantha Danielle Small. Haley Marie Smedstad. Alexis Victoria Smith. Jillian Rose Solomon. Anthony Joseph Sorrentino. Liam James Spence. Zachary Tyler Spinnick. Emma Christine Springer. Joshua John Spryzak. Naha Krishnan Shrether. Gabrielle Elizabeth Stangus. Hannah Kropa Stangus. Jessica Stafat. Noah Anthony Steiner. Christina Stevanovich. Kelsey Elizabeth Stuber. Venkat Subramanyam. Dalton Sutherland. Min Tan. Elizabeth Jayla Taylor. Taya Tiroli. Amartya Sriram Tiwari. Shabam Kumar Tiwari. Christiana Toma. Lauren Teresa Toma. Maram Tomo. Lucas Aaron Toth. Victoria Tran. Oleg Trush. Alexis Elizabeth Van Hoff. Elizabeth Sheila Van Oyen. Kelly Nicole Verdun. Joseph David Black. Aubrey Hall Wachowski. Saori Sarah Wakai. Spencer Martin Worthman. Christian Michael Waters. Allery Samia Watkins. Sean Michael Wainick. Justin Michael Welk. Kyle Franklin Wells. Jack Andrew Wall. Arian White. Jasmine Monet Whitney. Austin Marcus Wilcox. Jacqueline Elise Willenbrock. Jared Wesley Willis. Sarah Catherine Wines. Alan Wu. Emily Agnes Robel. Peter John Robel. David Yang. Prathusha Yaruva. Vivian Yip. Kevin Inchul Yo. Jared Michael York. Jessica Lynn Zates. Stephen John Zarbo. Audrey Zhang. Grace Zhang. Christina Patsy Rotondo Ziski. Michael Cage Zamba Jr.
My honor to introduce an extraordinarily impressive, talented young man. He has a bold personality, and some may say he's larger than life. He's funny, he's satirical, and per his own characterization, nuanced. He's confident, creative, known by all of Athens, intelligent, mature, and something of a modern-day Renaissance man. While at Athens, the summa cum laude AP scholar has proven himself to be an accomplished bass musician. and writer and director of Orktoberfest. He's captain of our football team, writer, coach, and evaluator for future problem solvers and on their state board of directors. He's also an Eagle Scout. He's leader of our AP rally and a daily fixture of our school's broadcasts. Next year, this AP Scholar graduate will be a Michigan State Spartan. He will be part of the James Madison Residential College and will study political policy. Please join in welcoming your closing keynote speaker, Mitchell Wachowski.
Go any higher or no? No? Okay. I guess first before I start, I'd like to say, you know, there are lots of cool things about today, graduating, diploma, all of that. You know what? The coolest thing to me is that I finally get to learn what all of your middle names are. I have never known. Some of them, it's amazing. All right. All right. Good afternoon, board members, administrators, faculty, parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, distinguished guests, and of course, the class of 2017. We made it! We're finally here. We have all just walked across the stage as children, and we have walked off of the stage as children with very official-looking pieces of paper. Or, I guess not, because they're all empty, but... All right. We enter this place as Red Hawks, and we will leave as Spartans, as Wolverines, as Chippewas and Broncos, Eagles and Grizzlies, or even Flying Dutchmen. We will clear our wardrobes of the red and gold sweatshirts and embrace armoires filled with green, blue, brown, gold, and every color in between. It is an exhilarating time in all of our lives. And so, at this rather auspicious moment, as we venture out into the great beyond, I think it's prudent to look back on what we're leaving behind. A couple of months ago, I was out having dinner with my parents when my dad asked me something that stopped me dead in my tracks. He turned to me while I was enjoying a delicious Oaxaca burrito, which I will sorely miss at MSU, and asked me, "What was high school to you?" For what might have been the first time in my life, I was truly at a loss for words. I hadn't given it any thought. Maybe because it hadn't crossed my mind, or maybe I just didn't want to think about it. I mean, here I am, diploma kind of in hand, and part of me still thinks that tonight I'll be getting texts from Mark asking about the statistics homework. I guess that by acknowledging that all of this has come to its conclusion, I'm finally admitting that the scope of my life is due for a dramatic expansion. So, what was high school to me? When I first truly pondered the conundrum, I was, as many of us often are, drawn to cynicism and negativity. I thought about those times where I was drowning in homework looking for answers to questions that I didn't even understand. I thought that was Athens High School. I remembered all of the painfully awkward school dances in which I have tallied six separate incidents where I accidentally elbowed a girl in the face. Actually, I wrote the speech before prom, so that number is now seven. I thought that was Athens High School. I recalled all the times when I felt ostracized and outcasted, afraid and adrift, and I thought that was Athens High School. In moments like these, where we indulge the darkness, I have recently realized this one insurmountable truth. While healthy skepticism can be good, pure negativity will get you nowhere. Being a person that only says no will earn you a lifetime of dissatisfaction. But channeling your energies into something positive, into building something, that will lead you to a full and happy life. And so again, I thought to myself, what was high school to me? And then I remembered. I remembered the lunches spent keeled over in laughter over the discovery that one of my friends will take over three bites to eat a single grape. Where is she? Is she over there? Okay. I remembered the bus rides spent with the orchestra going to places like New York and Orlando, and how the hours never felt long if we filled them with joy. I remembered the October bonfires, where we feverishly discussed our dreams and aspirations as the college application deadline fast approached. I remembered my friends, people like Griff and Joey, Claire and Camille, Dustin, Justin, Mark. Those were the people that brought light into my life. On days where I felt down and out, if I leaned on my friends, then I could get through anything life threw at me. That was Athens High School. One clap, all right. But then I remembered more. I remembered the conversations in an AP government class inspiring me to go into public service. I remembered the encouragement I received to voice my opinions in newspaper. I remembered the fun I had writing wild and fantastical vocabulary stories in English. From running a rice farm in economics to directing a full-fledged production in orchestra, one common thread ran throughout. All of those wonderful moments, those days of jubilee, occurred because a teacher decided to light a fire, to fuel a passion, to change a life. And so, Mr. DeSantis, Mr. Flessa, Mr. Erla, Mr. Burns, Ms. Nagy, Mr. Quinn, and the rest of the staff here at Athens, I thank you from the bottom of my heart for making these 4 years so incredibly awesome for the class of 2017. That was Athens High School. And finally, I come to all of you, the class of 2017. I cannot tell you how grateful I am to have been a part of this class. There aren't many groups of kids that will stay all four quarters of a football game and continuously cheer the team on. Whether you were celebrating with us in victory or consoling us in defeat, it meant a lot to have a student body that was behind us. And don't think I'm self-centered. How could I not once again mention the fact that this year's senior-led soccer squad was the first team to ever win two regional finals in the same year? Simply amazing. It's the worst part about going last is that everyone takes all of your jokes beforehand, and at the end it doesn't feel as good. But this was a class that was also laser focused on its academics. The class of 17 embraced the notion that every child can find success no matter who they are or where they came from. And finally, this was a class that, over its 4 years at Athens, came together to raise $353,282. That went to helping troops stationed overseas, granting wishes to sick children, building schools in Haiti, and honoring a fellow member of the class of 2017 who is looking down on us today and smiling. The class of 2017 has proven that a group of individuals who come together and unify around someone or something can turn dreams into reality. I look around and I think, no, I know that you, me, all of us, no matter where we go or what we do, the bond that connects all of us right here, right now, in this moment, will remain. We are and always will be Athens High School. And so, Athens High School class of 2017, I'm going to end this little soliloquy of mine with a request. No matter what you do, don't live your life based off of numbers in an aggregate, off of the amount of zeros in a paycheck, off the number of bedrooms in your home, off the number of cars, promotions, vacations, all of it. If you can quantify it, throw it out the window. I ask you to instead strive to live a life focusing on the fullness of your hearts and the content of your character. Hug your friends just because you can. Tell your parents you love them. Call up the people in your life who matter to you and tell them why. Bring the positivity, bring the passion, bring the sense of joy and community to the world that I have seen firsthand here at Athens, and I promise your potential will be limitless. It was Jimmy Valvano who said that, to me, there are three things in life everyone should do every day. Number one is laugh. Number two is think. Spend some time each day in thought. Number three is you should have your emotions move you to tears. If you laugh, think, and cry, that's a heck of a day. Athens, I have laughed with you, I have thought with you, I have cried with you. I appreciate each and every one of you and what you have taught me. Now, let's go take the world by storm. Thank you.
And now, I get to introduce the person who will lead you in your last act as a class. She is someone who is kind, conscientious, and an unsung hero. She is passionate about serving others and a dedicated team player. She is someone you can count on both to lead and to support. This graduate is a summa cum laude AP NHS scholar. She is secretary for Students Against Drunk Driving, vice president of Student Congress, including seven-time American Red Cross blood drive chair. She is a Business Professionals of America state finalist and a varsity volleyball scholar athlete who has been a part of district, all region, and all county teams. Please join me in welcoming this future Bowling Green State University bound business, accounting, and finance major, Elise Leverenz.
Thank you, Dr. Dixon, for that kind introduction. What a great view I've had these past 2 hours. Looking out into the sea of red and gold and seeing everyone sitting together reminds me of everything we have done together. We have attended sporting events, musical concerts, and plays. We have hunted zebras at the zoo and have ridden the dragster at Cedar Point. And we have danced at prom together. We have raised a record of over $350,000 together for our charity weeks. Now, to signify that we have graduated and become part of the legacy of Red Hawks, let us turn our tassels from the right to the left together. May all that we have learned together take us far in life and give us the ability to chase our dreams. Board of Education, administrators, teachers, parents, grandparents, siblings, and friends, I proudly present to you the 2017 Athens High School graduates.
Congratulations to everyone and their family. And now, as alumni, we will walk out together. Thank you.
Thank you.